So for our next example problem, this problem came out CEBOR November 2018, or a similar problem rather, no? A similar problem came out CEBOR November 2018. So check na natin. So we have beam DEF daw is supported by spandrel beams at the exterior edges and by a column at E. So torsional resistance daw of beam ADG and CFI are not sufficient to restrain beam DEF at D and at F. Okay, so beam DEF. So meron tayong spandrel beam dito. Okay, however, the torsional resistance of beam ADG and CDF are not sufficient to restrain beam DEF at D and F. Okay, so for all beams down, we have BH is 300 by 450. For all column sections, we have 400 by 400 m. Again, take note, kanina, sa example problem natin, we are not given with the column section, which is why I assume, no, that the column section is just the same, has the same width, no, as the section of the beam, since based on the figure naman, more or less same naman sila. But however, if you were to look at the figure now, the columns are actually so much larger, no, than the beams. So dead load, we have 6 kilonewton, all weights included, meaning included na yung weight ng beam natin. If you were to look at the problem, WU na yan, so automatic, no need to factor. So question number one, which of the following though gives the critical negative moment for beam DEF? Now, this is actually a, this is importante ito, no, kasi we will actually apply all the parang all the checklist ba before we can actually use, no, directly the coefficients. Bakit? Number one, if you try to look at the spans, they are not the same. However, it follows the rule, no, na 20% less than 20% yung lamang ng 8 yung ng larger. And then next, one-way slab. I mean one-way, tama, one-way slab. And then next, ano pa ba? Two spans. Okay, so I think okay tayo dito. So for the critical negative moment, i-draw muna natin. Try natin i-draw yung coefficients natin dito para hindi kayo malito. Okay. So ito yun, no? And then meron tayo dito. Column, no? And then we have a beam here. Actually, beam yung dalawa. Anyway, yan lang yung ilagay ko. Yan. So, for the negative moment, I think we can both agree, no, na this is, yung negative na moment natin dito is W ln squared over 9. Diba? Kasi 2 span man. Okay. However, for the negative moment dito sa exterior, okay, sa interior face of the exterior supports, I think we can both agree this is W ln squared, sorry, ln squared over 24 due to the presence of, di ba, spandrel beams. Tama ba? I-check na natin yung notes natin. Tama, di ba? Ay, sana yun. Yan pala, di ba? Due to the presence of spandrel beams, this will be WLN squared over 24. Okay. So, I hope okay tayo dito, ha? Next. Ay, sorry. So, ang dalawa ba? Ang spandrel beam? Beam DEF, spandrel beams at exterior edges by column at E. Okay, so tama. Yung exterior edges daw are spandrel beams. So, base sa problem, so okay tayo. Next is, careful kayo. Kasi although this is a beam, so meaning, usually kasi pag beam, in this, yung span natin is integral with the support. However, notice that there is actually a condition given. Tingnan nyo. The condition is that the beam DF is, ano yun? The torsional resistance daw of beam ADG and CFI are not sufficient to restrain beam DF at D and F. Therefore, this is unrestrained pala yung D and F. And then, according to our code, di ba? Nasa code natin. Asa na yun? Yan o. Unrestrained. Di ba? Discontinuous unrestrained. We will have WLN squared over 11 as our positive moment to that span. Okay, so therefore, if I try to draw this, draw ko to dito, ang moment pala natin dito is WLN squared over 11. Same din dito. Over 11. Okay, now it's just a matter of solving for the clear spans. Okay? So again ha, careful kayo. Bakit? Kasi if you will try to solve, if you will try to use WLN squared over 16 or dito, then actually nasa choices yan. And then dito, di ba, nasanay tayo, that's 14. If you'll use a WLN squared over 14, then rest assured nasa choices din yan. So careful kayo talaga ha. So anyway, let's move on down. I mean, let's check daw yung question. So, critical negative moment of beam DEF. Again, from our figure, the critical negative moment of beam DEF will be WLN squared over 9. Now, just make sure that LN is the average span. So, solve natin. So, tawagin ko na lang yung isa na L1. That's 8M. Ang isa L2, that's 7M. And then, ang column, tawagin ko itong column na lang, C. Yung dimension ng column natin will be 400mm. Tama, no? 400mm. Ah, okay. Another thing din pala. Buti di ko nakalimutan. So, sa clear span, pag nag-clear span kasi tayo, dito pala. So, pag nag-clear span tayo, di ba, usually we subtract, di ba? Yan. Usually we subtract. Now, nasanay tayo na pag nag-subtract tayo, gagaya kanina, automatic, we just subtract the width of the column. Now, this time, if you will try to look at our figure, this is the column. However, these two are actually beam. Di ba yung kabilaan ba? Beam. So, iba yung i-subtract natin. So, for this one, for example, this is 8 meters. Ang clear span nito will be this one. Diba? Yan yung clear span. That is actually 8 minus kalahati ng column, which is 200, or kalahati ng beam, which is 150, or 0.15, minus kalahati din ng column sa gitna, which is 200, 0.2. Now, this is our clear span ngayon. Careful kayo, ha? So, ako nga, medyo, na-distract ako sa figure. Akala ko, anong tawag na, akala ko, beam yung nandito sa DEF. Okay? So, ilagay ko lang dito yung column, then yung beam, that's 300 mm. Okay, so let's solve. Maximum critical negative moment. The loads are already WU, so diretso na. Ano yan? So, M, tawagan lang natin ditong M1. M1 will be WU. So, diretso na lang natin, i-add na lang agad since na-factor naman. So, that's 6. Ay, kalimutan ko yung dead load and live load. Ano yung dead load natin? That's 6. And then, ang live load natin, that is 4.6. Okay, so, diretso na lang, i-add na lang natin yung dalawa. And then, over 9, no? However, yung LN natin must be an average LN. So, I will have an average of LN1 and LN2. So, solve muna natin yung LN1. So, LN1 will be 8. Okay? Or L1 pala. L1 minus C minus B. Yan. So, 7.3 pala yung LN1. While LN2 will be L2 minus C minus B. So, that's 6.3. And then, ang average ng dalawa, dito ko na lang ilalagay yung average. Tama. Dito ko na lang. So, LN1 plus LN2 over 2. WL, oh, tama, negative moment pala to. So, WLN squared over 9. Okay. So, okay lang. Nakuha ninyo yung sagot natin.
Yes, sir.
Sige, sige. Again, ha? Careful kayo, ha? Always, yung mga small details, yun kasi yung mga mas importante ba? Especially pag mga ganito klaseng problems. So, check natin for number 2. I think, hindi na tayo maluloko nito, no? So, for number 2, which of the following dog gives the critical positive moment for beam DEF? Again, if you will try to look at my figure, the critical positive moment for beam DEF, both are actually WLN squared over 11. Diba? Equal sila sa coefficients. However, one of them is obviously larger since larger yung isang span. Okay? And that is the span DE. So, ilalagay ko lang dito. So, yung LN1 yung mas malaki, no? So, kopyahin ko na lang to. Lagay ko dito M2. Kopyahin ko yan, but instead of 9, diba, that will be 11. And then, instead of the average LN, ang ilalagay ko dyan is yung LN1. Diba? Dalawa yan yung mga positive moment. However, yung mas malaki is obviously yung mas malaki yung span. Okay? Naintindihan lang sa number 2? Hello, tingnan niyo, oh. Dalawa yung positive moment natin. Ln over 11 at saka ln over 11, both are equal in coefficients. However, sa value, you not need to check. Obviously, mas malaki talaga yung, mas malaki yung span. Okay lang? Hello, hello?
Okay na, sir.
Yes.
Sige, sige. So, next tayo. Ayan. Last, we have, determine the critical shear force for beam DEF. Again, I think we know, alam na natin yun, yung shear force critical, that's 1.15 W L over 2. Okay? So, same pa, I mean, 1 point, tama. Same pa din, we have two equal coefficients. However, one of them will be larger, which is yung mas malaki ang span. Tawagin na natin dito, V2, V3 pala. So, kopyahin ko na lang to. And then, I'll just multiply this band by 1.15. Change this one to 2. And then, tanggalin ko yung square. Diba? 1.15 WU L over 2. Again, ha, do not make the mistake of using the average kasi baka nasanay kayo ba, uy, ano tawag dun? Adjacent, diba? Hinahanap yung shear, tapos nandito yung shear. So, adjacent siya. Meron siyang dalawang adjacent. So, i-average, no. You will only use the average if you are solving for the negative moment. Other than that, then just use the normal clear span. Okay, so with that, we will have a negative moment na, I mean, we will have a shear na, yan, 44.4935. Okay lang tayo dito?
Yes, sir. Clarification lang, sir.
Ah, sige, sige.
Interior negative moments is average sa dalawang span.
Yes, yes, interior negative moments. Actually, lahat ng interior negative moments will be average sa dalawang span.
Tapos, same po sa shear na interior shear is average sa dalawang span.
Hindi, hindi. Eps. Sa code. Ah, ito pala. So, average lang. Ayan o. Average for the negative moments. However, for the shear, no need to solve for the average. Kung mapapansin nyo sa solution ko, wala, hindi na ako nag-average. Tingnan nyo. Diba? Yung ginamit ko talaga is yung clear span na dito. Okay? Now, pwede ko sanang gamitin din to yung clear span dito. However, this will be smaller. Ang tinanong kasi is critical shear force. So, you will only have the average if negative moment, a negative moment only.
Okay.
So, yun na, di ba? Tricky kasi, again, if you have the, you'll use the average, nandun din yan sa choices. So, careful kayo, ha? Sige, sige. Okay na?
Okay, sir.
Sige, sige. Hi guys, counting correction pala, sorry. Anyway, same pa rin yung concept talaga, nakalimutan ko lang. So, instead of L1 minus C and minus B, kung mapapansin nyo, whole width yung na minus natin sa column and sa beam. So, actually, dapat kalahati lang sana, kalahati sa column and then kalahati din sa beam. Anyway, same pa rin yung concept talaga. So, yan, wala tayong problema. Sige, salamat.